Applauding Life After 50 on BCTV is underwritten by White Star Travel Center.
Welcome to Applauding Life After 50. I'm Stephanie McMahon. I'm the marketing director at Berks Encore, and I have the pleasure of two wonderful guests today from Berks Encore as well. I'd like to introduce you to Rita Phillips, Vice President of Community Outreach, and Ashleigh Mills, our care manager. Welcome, ladies.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us.
It's nice to have you here, and our goal today is to talk about the Care Plus program. I know it's been some time since we've talked about this, and so we definitely want to provide all of the information we can to answer questions that you might have about Care Plus. But first, I was hoping that each of you could share with us your background and what you do at Berks Encore.
Sure, I'd be happy to, Steph. First of all, again, thank you for having us. My primary responsibilities at Berks Encore is to the oversight, the growth, and the communication of and the promotion of Care Plus. Care Plus is a fee-for-service service that Berks Encore offers, and we're looking to grow it and to make it available to everyone who needs it in the community.
Wonderful. I know, yeah, it's great that we provide a program that helps seniors and their caregivers, right? And helping them with their particular needs. Mm-hmm. So great. And Ashleigh, how about you?
So I'm the care manager for Care Plus and also home delivered meals, which Berks Encore is very known for. Care Plus, as the care manager, I help individuals, caregivers, older adults navigate the complicated aging system so that they can be linked to the resources that they need. I've been in aging for about 4 years now, and hopefully many, many more, and loving it.
Great. So you're getting out and meeting the clients face-to-face, which is really a great opportunity. It really helps us learn about what the needs are and what, you know, what we can help them with. So that's wonderful. Let's talk a little bit about the role of a care manager and information about, you know, who we help with Care Plus.
Care Plus is a program that's designed to provide assistance to older adults, to family members with aging parents or loved ones or caregivers. We create a customized plan to help their loved ones age with confidently and with a lot of dignity. We connect clients to providers of services within the community, and we support the caregivers to alleviate the stress that comes with caring for an aging parent or a loved one.
That's wonderful, because I know a lot of people who do have aging parents also work full-time and have their own family, right? So it's very important that they receive the support they need for both their parent or loved one and themselves, really.
Right. So we try to make it, we can't say stress-free, but we try to make it easier to navigate all the things that they might need.
That's wonderful. Good. Well, what types of support can Berks Encore Care Plus provide?
It can be very vast. Every time I walk into a home, the need is different. So I never like to say, we do this, this, and this, because we can do many things in many different capacities. For instance, sometimes they like to bring me in because family discussions can be difficult, and I act as a mediator for the family, on top of linking them to resources for their various needs. The other day, I helped someone set up a medication dispenser system and order that and get that delivered. It's quite varied.
Wow, that's a great example. And of course, just one example of the many things that we can help with. Well, how would someone get started with Care Plus?
Well, the first step is, first of all, they hear about us, they research it on our website. We have a lot of information about Care Plus on our website. And once they have an interest, they would call us. And there's a complimentary initial phone consultation that we ask questions to see what their immediate needs are, to determine what things they might need to address immediately, what things they're looking for long range. And from there, depending on what how that phone call goes, other steps follow.
I see. So if someone calls and they're interested in pursuing the next step past the initial phone conversation,
right,
based on the information they obtained, what can they expect from that conversation?
After we've had an initial assessment over the phone, then I would actually come into the home and meet with the family to really do our very lengthy, in-depth assessment so that we know step for step what the needs are, what's currently going on in the home, what brought them to us in the first place, and what the goals are. After we've done that, then I go back to my office and I create a care plan that covers all of those concerns, and then we begin our ongoing relationship.
So let's just back up a little bit and talk about the initial assessment in home. So what are some of the things that you're looking for or that you talk to a client and their family about?
Well, the first thing I ask is what brought you to us for me to come out today? And usually that gives more information than asking what their diagnosis are and what medications they're taking. Something brought them to us. There's a need, there's a concern, there's imminent risk that they're trying to mitigate.
And sometimes, right, people are wanting to stay at home.
Yes,
and that might be the main goal, is that I want to stay in my home, but my family's concerned about my safety and my well-being.
Absolutely. Most if not all the aging programs in the county are always concerned about keeping the older adult in the least restrictive environment in the home for as long as possible. And that's always the goal when we come out.
That's great, because you're really trying to meet the needs of the client, right? Mm-hmm. And they want to stay in the home that they've lived in their whole life or for a very long time and raise their family, and they have good memories there and things like that.
They do.
So that's great. So then you mentioned that then you go back to your office and you write a care plan.
Yes.
And what's involved in that? Then what happens next?
Once we've identified the goals that we've liked to work on together, then it's different every time. So if the goal is that the other day we had someone who was trying to stay in the home, be independent, but they keep forgetting to take their medication. So that's why we set up the medication dispenser system, so that it would actually alert them when it's time to take their medication, it would dispense them. And if they didn't take their medication, it would actually notify the caregiver that it wasn't taken, so that they can come in and make sure it gets taken. So little things like that, or sometimes people want help with nursing home placement if it has gotten that far and they need to start setting up visitations to check out the nursing facilities, the immense paperwork that's involved in those processes. The list goes on and on. But
so those are some things that we can help with through the Care Plus program. Oh, that's fantastic. All right. Well, once the plan is completed, Rita, what happens after that?
Once Ashleigh, the care manager, completes the plan, mm-hmm, they will then schedule a time to meet with the client, the family, whoever is meeting and making the decisions. And they will review the plan to make sure, first of all, that everything was understood during the assessment and the plan is created based on what their needs are. And then you determine who's going to do what. Mm. There are things that a care manager can do that they don't have to go to an outside source. We can take care of for them. So once that's reviewed, then it's determined who's taking care of what, so that things get done on that checklist, mm-hmm, and things are accomplished the way they would like them to be done.
Wow, that's great. And so it gives everyone a role in the process. And I guess it sounds like Care Plus can handle as much or as little as the family is interested in.
Exactly.
Which leads me to a question about fees. So how does the fee structure work for someone who's interested in Care Plus?
The fees, first of all, there, as we mentioned, the initial consultation phone call is complimentary, so there is no fee involved. However, if they decide they want to move forward, Berks Encore has developed a sliding fee. It's based on the client's income, not family income, the clients who will be covered by the plan, their income. And what that initial fee covers is the in-depth assessment. It covers the creation of the care plan and the review of the care plan with the family. And again, the maximum fee is $299. But again, it's based on a sliding scale and it's based on their income. So that would determine what that fee is for that
service. Okay, great. And that's something that we talk to them about throughout the process to let them know. And then if there's a determination of, oh, we'd like you to do this service and help us, you know, then we talk about what those fees would be.
Right.
For
and then there's
help.
Right. There's hourly fees then based on the services that they would want and the time that it would take. So it's an hourly fee, again, on a sliding scale based on their income. So it depends on their income, what they would pay for the service.
Okay, great. Well, I know we work with a lot of organizations and agencies and such that we refer clients to. Can you just give us an overview of some of the organizations that we work with?
Right. So we deal with the Berks County Area Agency on Aging quite a bit. Berks Encore, of course, for home delivered meals is always the top of our list. Depending on the need, we may refer to financial planners, estate planners. Oftentimes they want to arrange funeral arrangements, so we will link them to, I know Coons is one that's most commonly referred to. Absolutely. Home healthcare agencies in the area, there's so many, I could rattle off a dozen off the top of my head, always referring to very good home healthcare agencies, local nursing homes.
So a really wide array of
absolutely
of community providers that help with aging services. Mm-hmm. So if we don't have a contact, we definitely reach out and do the research and find the right
absolutely
fit for the organization so that we can help our clients.
Right.
That's wonderful. So if a client is interested in contacting us, I know the number's a little bit different than calling Berks Encore. So I definitely want to provide this kind of throughout the show. So if you're interested in learning more about Care Plus or talking about your particular situation and having that phone interview, the number's 484-577-4243. You can also email us at becareplus@berksencore.org. So it's very easy to get in touch with us. You can also go to our website, berksencore.org. Like Rita mentioned, we have a lot of information on our website about the Care Plus program.
Yes.
So there's a way to get in touch with us. So there are services that we don't offer through Care Plus. Like, what are some things that might come up that we, you know, someone might ask us and it's just not something that we offer?
We're not nursing. We don't provide any medical interventions. We're not a doctor, so we cannot provide any medical advice. We can't touch your medications. Bill pay and things like that are usually we like to refer to a financial planner. It's a bit hands-off with some things like that.
Okay, well that makes sense. Mm-hmm. Things that are more personal and of course concerning their health, we would mm-hmm. keep to the professionals that do that, but we can always refer them to find the appropriate doctor or based on their insurance and things, right?
Because yeah, and we obviously help. We're a source for information, but we're not making the decisions for you. The decision always has to be made by the family, so we're a resource, but we're not calling the shots.
Yes. And I know do we have a specific service area? Is it Berks County only? Like, how does that, we service older clients in Berks County now?
We serve primarily clients in Berks County. However, That doesn't mean that if somebody is living in a neighboring county that we couldn't step outside of Berks. Our primary care service area is Berks County.
Okay.
We do have a number of clients that the family lives outside of Berks County, but the parents live here, mm-hmm. and their concern is for how can we make sure that our parents are being taken care of or have the things that they need. So we serve a lot of those families to give them that peace of mind, knowing that somebody's watching over or checking in or, you know, however they want it to be managed, but we're there to service that.
That's wonderful, especially like you said, for families that are living out of town, mm-hmm. they have their own families, they're not able to care for their parents directly every day.
Right.
So we can help make arrangements to ensure their peace of mind, which yes. is mm-hmm. really important. And it's, I think, one of the most important parts of this program is giving the family and the client peace of mind.
Absolutely.
And getting the help they need. So that's fantastic. Let's talk a little bit about our program and how we extend our program to businesses in the area, like meaning corporations and how they're using our services through CarePlus.
Currently, we have several companies in the Berks County area that have signed an agreement and have asked Berks Encore to be a resource for their employees. They know that it's difficult for their employees to take care of an aging parent or a loved one and also be a full-time worker and dedicate the time and be available for what they need them to do at work. And so they see this as a benefit, and they offer it as a benefit to their employees and pick up the cost for that initial assessment and care plan so that the employee isn't paying out of pocket. So that's a benefit that they can secure through their company, and we're proud to have partnered with several companies in the area and looking to grow that, because as companies know, you know, they need to depend on their employees, but their employees can't always dedicate 100% because they have these things, these issues. The parent has to go to a doctor appointment, they have to take off for that, or they have to, you know, so what they're looking for is a way to help them manage the care of their parents or loved ones. So
what a wonderful service, really. Mm-hmm. I mean, to help, I mean, not only for, you know, the individual, the employee, providing them a service that can help them, but then also ensuring that the employee has the productivity and is giving right. back to the organization to the right level.
Right.
It's just a win-win, really, for everyone.
It is. So it's it's a great benefit.
Yeah, it really is
to their employees.
Oh, that's wonderful. Let's talk a little bit more about some scenarios. I know I think one of the things we do want to stress with this is that this is. CarePlus is unique to the individual. It's unique to the client, right? Everyone has different needs. And so the goal of this program is to tailor it to that particular client. But can you give some more examples of situations that might help someone go, oh, wow, that mm-hmm. sounds really similar to what I'm dealing with. Wow, I wonder if they can help me help my parent.
Mm-hmm. So some common things that we come across, medication dispensing is a big problem. Older adults forgetting to take their medication is always a concern. In addition to that, a big concern amongst older adults is falls, especially while they're alone in the home. So we really do focus on fall prevention and making the safe home, the home safe in the event of a fall. So there's some easy solutions to that. But there are many more varied devices that can be used in a home. So the most common one is the life alert button, right? They wear it around their neck, they have it on their wrist. If they fall, they hit the button. But wouldn't you know it, there's a lot of older adults out there who really don't like to wear those. It's not very fashionable. Maybe if it goes in the wrong direction, they're accidentally pressing it. So it can be, you know, a hindrance to that. And then that obviously concerns caregivers, because if they're taking it off and then walking around and they don't have it, they still don't have that sense of security that their older adult is safe. So there are other devices that can be placed around the home. Most recent one I found is a wall-mounted voice-activated button that can be put on the base of the walls. So if you have fallen, you can actually, you don't have to stand up to reach the button. You could voice activate it, or you could crawl over and hit the button because it's low to the floor. Also having those in the bathroom is very helpful. Modifications to bathrooms. The shower is the main place where a lot of falls occur. So we do talk about that a lot. Doing modifications to the bathroom, setting them up with local contractors, PA licensed contractors, to get that up to safety regulations so we eliminate the risk of fall in the bathroom. Stair lifts are always a great thing we link them to. Ambulating stairs is another fall risk, and one really big thing that makes or breaks someone being able to stay in their home or not, if they can do those steps.
Definitely, yes. I mean, if you can't do steps,
and you have, you know, two levels, absolutely.
Yeah, it's either that or maybe making modifications to a room in the home that's on the first level where you can convert it to a bedroom.
Absolutely.
And that's something that, we can also help find a supplier to help do, moving furniture and, and things like that, things that are needed. Do you have anything else to add, Rita, as far as like other ideas or opportunities or things that people are looking for?
I would, and one of the things that in the visits that I've make is respite care for the caregiver. Sometimes the caregiver is overwhelmed. They don't have time to do or take a break for themselves. Excuse me. So we're able to help them find caregivers that would come to the home and give them some time away, so that they can refresh themselves, because if they can't refresh themselves, they're not there to give the care they need to their loved one. So I think that's another big one that I've heard in a number of the visits that I've made. So
definitely,
I think it's important.
I think another common trend, and I think you'd agree with this because we've encountered it quite a bit, is social isolation for the older adult, and linking them to several of the programs in our area, like Diacon, who has the senior chat program that links seniors with seniors who have similar interests, that they can chat on the phone, because not oftentimes they're not able to travel, or we can't find volunteers for friendly visitors. It's another nice option to alleviate that social isolation aspect that often happens in aging.
Well, that's wonderful, and have someone checking in with just a phone call or just stop by and visit for a while. It's definitely a big concern for people that are living alone. That's wonderful. Anything else that you can think of that, you know, one of the things I was thinking about was people with Alzheimer's or dementia, you know, having a loved one, you know, a wife caring for a husband or vice versa, and, you know, the fear of them leaving the home, maybe when they're in the restroom or they're taking a nap and, you know, not knowing really where they are and getting lost or anything like that. I know there's safety devices out there. We could help with that.
I think the most common thing nowadays is those Ring cameras. They can set them up indoors. There's a whole bunch of nifty devices that can monitor, even if they were to leave the house, pop out for a quick 15 minutes to go to the grocery store. They can check on the older adult. I believe there are alarm systems for the doors if they're to open, that the caregiver would be alerted. Older adults with dementia do tend to wander, not always, but that's always a very concerning situation.
Yeah, so I can see, you know, that being a good opportunity for us to come up with a detailed care plan to help someone in a situation like that.
Right. And I think, as Rita had mentioned, finding respite for the caregiver, someone else who can come in and care for the older adult while they step out and do the grocery shopping, go to their medical appointments, is really important to avoid that situation.
Yeah, so CarePlus is really not only for the senior client or the older adult, it's definitely for the family members. It's to help them from, you know, getting tired out. And, you know, I think people lose patience sometimes when they're, you know, helping someone continually. And it's always nice to have a fresh set of eyes come in and provide recommendations on a better way to handle the situation at hand. And I think Care Plus is the answer to that problem.
I think it helps the son or the daughter be the son and the daughter and not always that caregiver and not always the one that has to push the parent, because that's difficult. That's a difficult situation, you know, when role reversal. And so it allows them to be the son and the daughter and to give them a break from some of that and be the family member that they love being.
Yeah, exactly. And I think, too, it helps with, like you mentioned, being a mediator for family mm-hmm. members who, yeah. you know, you have siblings that want to both take control of the right. situation and mm-hmm. helping their parents, and they don't necessarily agree on what the solution is.
Yeah, the family dynamic can get a little stressful because it's almost as if the older adult is now the child and the child is now the parent, and they don't like that. So to have an unbiased, you know, third party in the situation that can kind of get them to see that the older adult has a lot of power in this situation. They have an opportunity right now to create a care plan that keeps them safe, but also that keeps family members, gives them that peace of mind.
Mm-hmm. Great. Well, on that note, I think Care Plus is a fantastic program. It's really a great opportunity that if you or your loved one are having a difficult time and you need help, Berks Encore, Care Plus, we can help you. Give us a call. You can reach us at 484-577-4243, or you can email us at becareplus@berksencore.org. I thank you both for being here today. I think it's very enlightening, and I hope it helped our audience. And if you're in need of help, please give us a call.
Thank you, Steph.
Thank you.
Applauding Life After 50 on BCTV is underwritten by White Star Travel Center.